Hi there, and welcome back to Batshi Cooks with Chutzpah. We are going to make today an amazing, unique spaghetti. Now, when people think about spaghetti, they usually associate it with Italian cuisine. But I do have a surprise for you. Did you know that the Persians, the Iraqis, basically the entire Middle East have their own version of spaghetti called macaroni? Even in ancient Greece, it was called macaroni. Some of the greatest benefits to this dish are: it does not include heavy cream, does not include cheese, and no grated Parmesan, and no butter, which means less cholesterol, less fat. So I will not make you wait any longer. Let's go for it. There is half a package of macaroni or spaghetti. You can use gluten-free pasta. The water is boiling. I'm adding the pasta. We let it cook probably 15 minutes. Now, the fun part. I have 1/3 of oil. For this dish, I use vegetable oil. I think it tastes better. Once it's heated, I sauté one large onion. We sauté it really good. I add 8 cloves of garlic that I chopped, and I sauté more. By the way, if you are making an entire package of spaghetti, here I made half the package, which is almost 8 ounces, because the whole package is almost 16 ounces. You just double everything. So now the garlic is ready. I have here a teaspoon of sweet paprika, a teaspoon of ground cumin, half a teaspoon of curry. I add it all to the onion mix. You want to sauté the flavor also a little bit. 3 tablespoons of tomato paste, and work it a little bit again. 3 tablespoons of ketchup. Then an entire can of diced tomatoes with its juice. For this specific dish, we cannot incorporate Italian flavored diced tomatoes in a can. So please just get plain canned tomatoes. Here we have fresh red bell pepper. You add a teaspoon of salt and half a teaspoon of ground black pepper, but it's up to you if you would like to add more of it. Can you believe it is done? So the spaghetti is cooked. It is time to taste the sauce. I think it might need another teaspoon of ketchup. We'll take a new spoon, add it while the burner is still hot, taste it again. Yeah, mommy, yeah. Perfection. This dish tastes amazing even the next day. We mix it lightly. You don't want to mash it. When I eat it, it takes me back to childhood, to the most amazing memories. And I hope when you make it and then when you eat it, it takes you back to wonderful places in your life. Voila! Enjoy. Please subscribe, give me like, and share. See you soon. Bye.